We are Hudson and Scotty B, the Bizarro Morning Show, and it gives us great pleasure to welcome right here to the Roadrunner Music Hall,
Ori Anthe. Yeah, she comes.
Hi.
And you have someone following you here.
I do. He's my guitar player and musical director, Brian.
Yeah. All right. We met Brian. Brian's awesome.
Round of applause for Brian as well, everybody. He's going to work. Now, it's kind of a neat thing today because, you know, I think most of the stuff that we've seen you do has been with the electric guitar just wailing on it. But you're going back and doing acoustic today for us.
Yeah, I'm going to break it down a little.
But your background really started with classical guitar, correct?
Yeah, it did. I picked up guitar when I was 6, and then I went and studied classical when I was 10. I was there for about a year or so, and then I saw Carlos Santana perform with my dad, and that was kind of the turning point for me. So I picked up the electric guitar after that show. So I want to do what he's doing. So I studied all of his records and was pretty much obsessed with his playing and just the way he played, put so much passion in his notes and everything, and it was just incredible. So I became a huge fan and studied all of his solos. I think I learned nearly every one of his songs, and then he came to Adelaide and I got to jam with him, and that was just a very surreal moment, crazy moment.
Wow. And can I ask you, how old are you? You're pretty young.
I'm 25.
25 years old and plays so beyond her time. It's just, it's remarkable. It really is. And you know, we've got a lot of questions we're going to hit you up in between. Let's warm this thing up.
Yes. All righty.
Trying to forget the words that he told me yesterday, but nothing makes it easier. It takes my pain away. It was so hard, like I fell down on my back. I don't understand his reasons. You know I tried, but I can't. So I sung a love song before he left for me. Out in the blues, now it's gone. Dude, why didn't you tell me? It's been going on for so long, so I kept believing. All of his lies, you jump in the chair. Other plans, but I shouldn't be wasting my time. I try not to think about the way things could have been. He knew how much I loved him. He was my everything. And it hurts me inside when he treats me this way. I don't understand his reasons. I tried, but I can't, so I sung a love song before he left for me. Now it's in the blues, now he's gone. Baby, why didn't you tell me? It's been going on for so long, so I kept believing. All the ups and lies, you jumped on the chance, made other plans. Baby, I shouldn't be wasting my time. And all of the promises he made, well, now I can't go back there again. I can't stay this way any longer. I can't hold on any longer, alright. So I sing a love song before he left for me. In the blues, now it's gone. Baby, why didn't you tell me? It's been going on for so long, so I kept believing. All the ups and lies, you jumped on the chance, made other plans. Baby, I shouldn't be wasting my time. Sung a love song before he left for me. Now it's in the blues, now it's gone. Baby, why didn't you tell me? It's been going on for so long, so I kept believing. All the ups and lies, you jumped on the chance, made other plans. Don't be wasting my time. So slide over here, 'cause I got to let you know. makes me sweat.
Oh, Orianti, a little NXS there, huh?
Okay, that was awesome.
Put that in there, Ozzy.
Very awesome. Nice. Very nice. Again, Orianti today here at Orianti. Well, we talked about this when we had you on the radio a couple weeks ago. Pronounce it correctly for everyone for us.
Orianti.
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 Yes. We get to call her Ori, though. Right?
Yeah, Ori's much easier.
It's so much easier for us because you know what? We've said it so many different ways because when we first heard your name, we were saying Orianti.
Orianti, I think.
Yeah, we've tried it so many different ways, and we're just going to go with Ori.
There you go. That'll make it simple. Definitely. Now, you just finished up some time with another guy that was recently here, Adam Lambert, correct?
Yeah, we had a blast on the Glam Nation tour. We were on that tour for about 3 months, and so much fun. It was my first real tour, getting the tour bus and a fabulous band, and we're out there on the road and playing, I think, nearly every night. So we really learned a great deal, and from when we started, like, we used to film all of our shows, and when we started, we're just kind of like standing there, like really, really still. And then we sort of viewed the tables, like, we've got to be more interesting. So we started running around the stage and having a blast. And it was just such a learning thing for all of us. And we loved it. And his show was amazing.
He's such an out there crazy guy.
He is. He's super cool. I mean, his
super
voice
cool.
is amazing.
Who took longer getting dressed?
He did.
Okay.
Definitely. No.
Who wears more makeup?
He did.
He did. Oh. Yeah, he totally does. We dug him when he was here. All right, we're ready. We got more. Put it together. Everyone, let's get your hands together for Orianti. Or Ori.
Ori.
I got to turn on my guitar right now. I just turned it off. So. It sound good. And again.
Okay.
Orianthe working it for you today. And also Brian over at
Brian.
You know, I got to know, Brian, was it a little bit intimidating when you took a job working with such a great guitarist as that? Do you feel like she's looking over your shoulder?
No, I don't look at it like that. You get to learn a lot. Definitely get to learn a lot. She's, you know, definitely one of the best in the world. So it's been, been an honor to play with her.
Yeah, hands down.
Been an honor.
Brian's awesome. He's Brian amazing is. Player.
Oh, you're awesome.
No, you're awesome.
No.
No. Okay, let's not do this right here.
So, no, you guys have been here for a couple of days. Sorry that we had a little bit of rain. What so far has been the coolest thing you've done while you've been here?
Coolest thing I've done. We got in like the other night. We wanted to walk. We got lost. I went on a walk with my sister. We kind of got lost. She found the way back, which is awesome. So, but it was beautiful. I mean, we just went shopping. I got to hold a macaw. It was this guy who was holding these two like
on the street
birds.
In Waikiki.
Yeah, he was holding these two big birds.
Let me guess. He tried to take your picture. And then sell it to you.
For like
$10? No, actually, it was free. I just asked him if I could hold his bird, and he gave me the bird. And
really?
It was huge, like macaw. And,
okay.
And,
he must have known it. Who you were, okay, because they charge for that.
Really? Or maybe I should have given him money. I feel bad now.
No.
He's probably just waiting for me to pay him.
No, believe me, he overcharged some
like
tourist.
Cheapskate.
This is going to get into the tabloids now.
It is.
Orianthe comes to Hawaii.
Okay, right?
And we give her the bird. All right. You know, I was going to ask you about, matter of fact, brought it up on Netflix just to watch your part again, the This Is It with Michael Jackson, which was something that your life was headed toward, and then suddenly that ended. And I was just wondering, though, even though you never got to actually put on the shows that were planned with Michael, what did you learn from him while putting together that big performance?
Just so much. He was such an entertainer, just incredible musician, perfectionist, and... just made me really step up, working with his, you know, entire band and obviously working with Michael. I mean, he just, he would change it up all the time. Like when we would run through Beat It or Dirty Diana, I'd be prancing around following him on the stage, but he'd always change where he was going to be. And so I always had to sort of look up and sort of like seeing where I'm playing, you know, I'd concentrate on sort of walking around. So I would practice a lot in my apartment, my dogs, be like, my loud amp, and it was actually kind of funny because I had this really loud amp in my apartment, and I was playing all the MJ riffs, and they probably thought this crazy MJ fan with a really loud amp has moved in next door to us. And so yeah, I mean it was so much fun. It was a real just highlight of my life getting to work with such an incredible entertainer, musician, just, and he was a great person too, you know, just.
How did it all come about? Real quick in a nutshell, because we want to hear you perform more, but I want to know, like, what was the feeling when you were asked to play?
Everyone was really emotional. I remember that night, he came in and sat down on the couch and right in front of us with Kenny Ortega, and he said, can you guys go in to Beat It? And I want to hear it really loud. And when he came in, I was just like, oh my gosh, it's MJ right there, and yeah. I got to play, and I've never been that nervous in my life, like ever. I was like freaking out. I was thinking, how do I play guitar again? You know, I'd gone over it a gazillion times, and I'm like, I was just praying to God I'd get it right, and I'd get hired, and we went in to Beat It, and straight after that, we played, I think, Dirty Diana and Wanna Be Starting Something, and then he spoke with Kenny, and he said, you guys are all hired. So we found out that night we didn't have to wait too long because, I mean, that would just killed me. I've been waiting for, like, even a night. I wouldn't be able to, you know, sleep. But all you guys are hired, and we just – it was just really emotional for everybody. We're just hugging each other, and, like, this is incredible. And those 3 months were just amazing.
Now, I know it's not an electric, but can you do a riff? A little mic?
Oh, it's going to sound really weird, but –
amazing. If anybody can do it, you can. Okay, one more thing, according to you.
Is that an autobiographical song? What is that?
You know, this song is actually written by Steve Diamond Andrew Frampton. Thank you, Brian. sorry, I can't remember. He has an amazing memory. I can't remember anything. He's awesome. They're both awesome writers, and I just loved it lyrically, you know, and when I first heard it was very pop, so I sort of made it, so I rockified it out of the guitar solo, and you know, I really relate to this song because, you know, it's about self-esteem, it's very empowering, it's like getting out of a bad situation.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, if I'm gonna play a song that someone else has written, the lyrics have to be very compelling. And this song really, affected me. I just really like the lyrics for it, and it's great when we play shows and seeing everybody, in the audience, and they're singing along and just having fun, and it's a feel good track. So
it is, and you have women who can totally relate to that track.
Yeah, which is great.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's hear it, Orianthe.
All righty.
According to you.
According to you, I'm stupid, I'm useless, I can't do anything right. According to you, I'm difficult, hard to please, forever changing my mind. I'm a mess in a dress, can't show up on time, even if it would save my life. According to you, according to you. According to him, I'm beautiful, incredible, he can't get me out of his head. According to him, I'm funny, irresistible, everything he ever wanted. Well, everything is opposite, I don't feel like stopping, and so baby, tell me what I got to lose. He's into me for everything I'm not, according to you. To you, I'm boring, I'm moody, and you can't take me any place. According to you, I suck at telling jokes, cause I always give it away. I'm a girl with the worst attention span, you're the boy who puts up with that. According to you, he's into me for everything I'm not, according to you. I need to feel appreciated, love not hated. Well, oh no, why can't you see me through his eyes? It's too bad you're making me decide. You're stupid, you're useless, you can't do anything right. But according to him, I'm beautiful, incredible, he can get me out of his head. According to him, I'm funny, irresistible, everything he ever wanted. Well, everything is opposite, I don't feel like stopping, and so baby, tell me what I've got to lose. He's into me. According to you. According to you.
There you go. Orianthe. Nice job, Brian. We do have Pixie out in the audience right now. She's going to prance over with a microphone. Here she goes.
And
we have a couple of audience questions for you, if you don't mind, Ori.
Yeah, of course.
Hey, Orianthe. Huge fan. Could you give us the very quick rundown of your guitar rig from guitar to amp?
Yeah, definitely. I use PRS guitars, and I love them. My favorite guitars in the world. And I actually have my own model now of the PRS, and I use that a lot too, the SE. I plug that straight into an EVH amp, which I love. They just really go well together, the PRS and the EVH. 5150, the white one. Yeah, it's the EVH now, so. And I use that for my record, actually, for Believe, for all the solos and everything I was plugging into that amp. And it just really sounds good live, and you can get that real distorted sound, and then have that real sort of mellow sort of rhythm channel sound, and a lot of clarity to it. So I use a Wah, I use TC Electronics, G-Force, and I use a harmonizer pedal, like through there, and delay, reverb, I'm not really into using a lot of pedals, but you know, it definitely adds a lot of sort of colors to the sound sometimes when you need it. So that's pretty much my rig.
Well, duh. Didn't you know that?
Now he's going to go out and get all that and test it out tonight.
That was like somebody explaining computers to me. I had no idea what just happened.
Right. Oh, and I use 9 to 42s on strings. Well, 9 to 42, 9 to 46s. 9 to 42, that's what I use. Yeah, there we go.
All right, Pixie, do we have a question in English? Okay, go ahead.
Why Jell-O? I was just wondering if you could sign my guitar.
I would love to.
That's my question, yeah.
Oh, definitely.
That was a fantastic question.
That was awesome. Question. That was, yeah. That was a great attention getter right there.
That was great.
Definitely.
Okay.
One more from someone.
Oh, from my little guy. He's been dying to ask you this.
What did Michael Jackson last say to you before he died?
Oh, wow.
He just said that he was really happy. He was really happy with everybody. And I just remember him joking underneath the stage. He had we all had our in-ears in, and we could hear him underneath. He would say in an operatic voice, he would say, that's what rehearsals are for. Because if you know he couldn't get dressed in time or something wouldn't be just right, he would always say that. And he said it in this sort of operatic, really, really high voice, and then started laughing. And that's kind of my last memory of him, and him just coming over and smiling. So he was in really good spirits that night, and always remember him that way.
Wow, the deepest question of the
day.
Wow,
yeah. Comes from an 8-year-old.
From Julian. Hey, can we take a quick moment here? I wanted to introduce someone who's walked into the room as well, putting on the production today.
Oh,
Tom Moffitt is here, everybody. Round of applause for Tom Moffitt.
Legendary Tom.
Hawaii legend. Well, now, do you have anything else you want to add before we let you vacate the stage?
I just wanted to thank you all for being here today. Great jamming out acoustically. And we can't wait to play tonight, supporting Train at Bandcamp. I'm super excited because that's where Aloha from Hawaii was shot with Elvis. And I'm a huge Elvis fan, so it's very, very cool to be getting on that stage.
Well
yeah.
You still have a stage and you still have a guitar.
You want to do one little riff of Elvis?
Oh, we're going to, but I don't know if that's going to... All right.
Who wants to hear a little Elvis here?
Come on, Ori. Just a little quick riff.
Hanaho, as we say.
Yeah, you're going to learn that tonight.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. You ain't never caught a rabbit, no, you ain't no friend of mine. Well, they said you were high class, but that was just a lie. Well, they said you were high class, but that was just a lie. You ain't never caught a rabbit, no, you ain't no friend of mine.